CIUT 89.5 FM, the sound of your city. Stream us anytime at www.ciut.fm.
The views and opinions expressed on the following program are those of the producers and or the persons appearing on the program and do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of CIUT FM.
Well, make me see you one up there. I make me see you one up there.
What's up, HOWL fans? Today is Tuesday, November 1st, 2022. Happy All Souls and Saints Day. On the show tonight, we're going to be talking to Ivan Bydak, who's written a new book called Invisible from Guernica Editions. And then in the second half, we're going to be talking to Alessandra Nacarada, who has written a book called Imminent Domains, Reckoning with the Anthropocene. It's a collection of essays. Really hoping that you can stick around for the hour. I very much enjoyed both of the conversations. This is HOWL on CIUT 89.5 FM. My name is Valentino Assenza. Let's do this. We are on Twitter at HOWL895FM. We are also on Instagram at HOWL895FM. Please give us a follow for those wonderful poets out there that want to send some poetry to hear on the radio. There is going to be a HOWL open mic for November. It's actually going to be on Tuesday, November the 29th, 2022. The submissions are due by Wednesday, November 23rd, 2022. MP3, M4A, WAV files, all welcome. Whether it's one poem or a collection of poems, please make sure that the recording is no longer than 5 minutes. Please send it off to howl@ciut.fm. Make sure November HOWL Open Mic is in the subject line. I look forward to your submissions. Thank you all so much. And I very much enjoyed the HOWL Open Mic from the last show, as well as the conversation that I had with Ian Kerekou and Jen Kasiyama. So for this show tonight, it's really interesting. I've two very unique books that are out there. One is by Ivan Bydak, who he's from the Ukraine. The name of his book is Invisible. It is fiction, but it is also sort of very much actually inspired by his journey with Tourette's syndrome. And it follows a character in the book by the name of Adam, who also has Tourette's syndrome, as well as two other characters that are dealing with their own afflictions. And it's very well written. And I enjoyed my conversation with Ivan. And then in the second half, we're going to be talking to Alessandra Nacarado. She's been on the show before. She was here for her poetry book, Reorigin of Species, but she's written a book. It's a collection of essays called Imminent Domains, Reckoning with the Anthropocene, a collection of essays sort of interweaving her connectivity with different, you know, parts of the planet in terms of sort of a geographical relationship, as well as an introspective one with the land and how it affects us and humanity. It's quite astounding. So we're going to get to our first interview. And Ivan Bydak, it was really wonderful meeting and speaking with him. He's a wonderful, wonderful person. And his book is called Invisible. Ivan Bydak is a daring Ukrainian fiction writer whose debut novel, Personally Me, Personally For You, became a national bestseller and garnered excellent critical reviews. His two short story collection, Role Plays and the Shadows of Our Dates, topped the bookstore sellers list. His latest novel, A Man With My Name, was excellent proof of the writer's maturity. He's written a book here called Invisible, and it was translated by Hannah Lalive and Isaac Wheeler, and I got a chance to talk to him about this wonderful book. Enjoyed my conversation very much, and here it is for you on CIUT 89.5 FM. Ivan, how are you?
Hey, Valentino. Yeah, nice to be here, nice to talk to you. I'm right now from Winnipeg, from my family's house. So it's all good. Thank you.
It's great. It's great to talk to you. Congratulations on your book. It told such a wonderful story, such an important story. I felt a connection to the three predominant characters that were there. And I appreciate you not only sharing your journey, but sharing theirs also.
Yeah, absolutely. Nice to hear that.
Now, I just want to start with the title itself. I mean, here I am. I've read the whole book, and I'm asking you about just the cover, the front cover. It shows sort of a photo. It's checkered and a bit distorted. And then the title itself has invisible. In is in brackets, and then visible is not in brackets. And I know that the character Adam at one time was talking about superheroes and superpowers, and he wished that his superpower would be invisibility. And it's an interesting thing because while Adam would want to be invisible, there's also a desire for visibility in what Adam's character and people alike are going through. Was that the intention that you had with putting the invisible, like the in part of it, in brackets?
Yeah, Valentino, I want to tell you that you noticed really great idea. And yeah, exactly. It was around this thing that those people who are trying to be like invisible at some point of their lives, they want to be visible. So it's pretty much the same time. They sometimes want to hide from all those stories and some prejudice they meet sometimes. But on the contrary, they do want to be visible. They want support and they want to be among others. So it's pretty much like what they face at the same moment.
Now, I know that Adam is he's been afflicted with Tourette's syndrome. And for the listeners here that don't know what Tourette's syndrome is, would you be able to tell us as to what that is?
Yeah, absolutely. So it's like involuntary movements of the body. It can be some jerks, coughs, or blinking eyes. So it is, other words, called nervous tics. And yeah, that's pretty much my story because I used to have Tourette syndrome. And I mean, I still have it, but it's mainly like a teenager disease. So 10, 15 years ago, I was like moving my body parts all the time and it was visible. And I'm really happy because like Tourette syndrome in general is getting a lot of attention and actually a lot of, you know, world celebrities do have this Tourette syndrome and they share their stories. So recently it was like Billie Eilish, Luis Capaldi. There's also ex-US national team, soccer team, goalkeeper Tim Howard. He also has Tourette syndrome, and they all share the awareness about this disease.
And you know, it's an interesting thing because Adam is basically the character in the story that has Tourette syndrome, and the book also mentions, of course, that. You're sort of telling your story a little bit through Adam, and it's just an interesting thing for me. I'm just very, it's my own curiosity, I guess. But what was it about Adam that helped you write your story through the conduit of his character? Like, why was Adam such a good vehicle to use instead of, say, just writing a memoir about your story?
Yeah, that's a good question again. And like, I really wanted to make it fiction, right? Because first of all, I'm a fiction writer, and I believe that even examples, you share the story way better rather than do like biography or sharing it from first narrative. So it was more comfortable for me on like second reason to tell like someone's story. So I want to say that in all those stories, like Adam, Anna, Ivar, Marta, they're all real people. So actually all those events which happened in the book actually happened in real life. I was interviewing those people. I knew those people. But for me, at some point, it was way more comfortable. Maybe I felt myself more courageous that way to say it from someone else's perspective. So that was the reason.
I mean, there was always from the reader's perspective, from my perspective, it was actually quite a wonderful thing to encounter the other characters of Eva and Martha, and the distinction of their characters too, and what they were struggling with was also an extremely relevant piece of the book in itself. But what I loved about it the most is how you sort of found community in how Adam found the community in these two other characters, and that was sort of a very important part of overcoming his challenges. And as you were writing this, I'm curious, were you having to sort of also research the afflictions that Martha and Eva had, as well as, you know, finding community in the people that helped to get you through?
Yeah, I mean, Valentino, again, like me myself, I was attending different like social support group, and I really believe that we as human beings, we really need to be united, and it's the only way we can feel some essence and support. And basically, no one wants to be left alone, especially people who are who look differently, right? So in this way, I really wanted to show that that only when you find some community, when you are trying to be into society, like people are gonna accept you. And secondly, yeah, most of people who have some, any type of visible disorders or whatever, they try to hide themselves. They try to be, first of all, invisible. So they just don't want this, interaction. But the truth is that we only get better when we do get this interaction, when we do have the support, and when we feel that we are not left alone. And that's pretty much like the only hint to anyone that we don't need to give up on our lives due to different types of challenges, and on the contrary, we'd rather find some ways out of it. So I really believe that this kind of community helped every person, and at some point of my life it helped me, because most of my time I was afraid. I didn't know how people would react to me, and that's why I chose to be invisible. But rather than that, at some point of my life, I decided to check how people are going to react, and I found it wasn't that scary, like, at all. It was, on the contrary, I just found support and, kind responses.
And with respect to this book, too, it sort of took a collaborative effort to get it out. I mean, obviously you wrote the story, but an important part of the book as well is that it was translated, and I see that it was translated by Hannah, I hope I'm pronouncing the name correctly, Hannah Leliv and Isaac Wheeler. Can you talk about the process that you went through in collaborating with those two to translate your story?
Yeah, absolutely. So it's interesting because Hannah is she is a very prominent Ukrainian translator. She's young, but she's translated so many books, and right now she's considered like one of the best translators, like from Ukrainian to English. And it's very interesting because she is actually my neighbor, so we live in same neighborhood, so we could get on a coffee like any moment. So Hannah actually got some grant residence in Britain first, and she was interested to work on my book. So I felt really privileged because, I mean, she chose my book. So first of all, it was like interest her in the story, and eventually, when we found Veronica and basically all my family here in Canada, because I have family in Canada, so with collective efforts, we managed to work together and have this book translated. So Hannah and Isaac, they worked in combinations. They work in a pair because Isaac is American, he knows Ukrainian. So it was a very good way, since they both knew the context of both languages. And it was really nice to cooperate first with Hannah and then with Isak. And you understand that, like, translating this type of book, right, about inclusion, it might be hard due to the usage of correct terms, right? Mm-hmm. The language needs to be very accurate, not to use some improper terms. So we worked on it quite intensely, and I'm very happy with the translation. So I was extremely happy. Sometimes I was reading it with an idea, oh, that's a good book, that's a good text, and then I realized, oh, okay, it's my text. So I'm really happy with the work Hannah and Isa did.
It's a really beautiful story, Ivan, and my commendations. I know that a portion of the proceeds of this book are going to an organization called Help Heroes of Ukraine. Could you talk about this organization at all?
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks for mentioning it. I'm Ukrainian. Yeah, and Ukraine is in trouble right now. We have the war with Russia, and all those events happening right now, annually. Book launches, readings, presentations, it still end up talking about the war. Because, yeah, that's an important war between, like, democracy and autocracy in our world. So it's really important Ukraine to win. And regarding Help Heroes of Ukraine, the Chicago-based organization, which helps Ukrainians humanitarian needs, and it's organized also by my cousin, who is living in Chicago. So they're doing outstanding work, like the community in US as well as many communities in Canada, because I was in, like, Edmonton, Toronto, Calgary, Winnipeg, Montreal, and I see that all communities gathered to help Ukraine, and I'm extremely grateful for this, to all people both in Canada and US.
Yeah, and I mean, I think in terms of visibility, I think you're giving the Ukraine a little bit of visibility here in writing this book. I mean, for us, you know, we're over on this side of the ocean, and our biggest problems when we wake up in the morning are that maybe our internet's a little slow or whatever, right? There's a little bit of invisibility on our part that we really should be taking and paying more attention to the fact that Ukraine is going what it's going through, and also that the arts and culture community in the Ukraine is very vital and very relevant, and you know, your book and music from the Ukraine definitely needs to be amplified a lot more. Do you feel that?
Well, I definitely feel it. Like, first of all, I would say that I really feel, and I see, I witness this, a lot of information in Canada about Ukraine. So I wouldn't say that there's some lack of information. On the contrary, you're very into topic. And when I talk to people, when I watch the news, I really see a lot of, you know, objective information. So it's quite good. It's have a good overview here in the media, so it's really good. And regarding any, like, Ukrainian culture, well, Ukraine and Canada have already had this tight connection due to a lot of waves of immigration back in, I don't know, early 90s. So I met a really big community of Ukrainians in Edmonton and Winnipeg. So I kind of feel like home, and yeah, my family makes me feel this way. I'm really, like, grateful, and I'm happy to see what I see. And of course, any type of modern culture, like music, literature, art in general, it is in brand right now in the world, but it's all due to armed forces of Ukraine. Mm-hmm. And, like, it's very common victory, I guess. So we all need to remember why we get this attention right now.
You know, I ask this often of my guests as I interview several authors, and I know that there was a part in the book where Adam was basically saying that we all have our own inner battles to overcome. Mm-hmm. And I always ask authors what they hope readers will get out of this book. Are you hoping that a reader will get an impetus, I guess, to keep fighting for whatever battles that personal or otherwise that they're going through?
Yeah, that's exactly. So it's a book about like hard topics, but again, it's a very warm book. So it's kind of a motivational book about tolerance, acceptance, about equality. So I wanted to show the world like different challenges some people are going through. And I believe it's a book for everyone because, yes, as you mentioned, we all go through some inner fights. And it's very important to first accept yourself and then try to live the best life you can, because we have only one life. And it's not very good probably to waste our life fighting with ourselves. So mm-hmm. I do believe that's what I wanted to share with the world. Hey guys, we have just one life, and we need to get the best of what we can.
This is CIUT 89.5 FM. My name is Valentino Assenza. You're listening to HOWL, and we've been in conversation with Ivan Bydak. The name of his book is Invisible, from Guernica Editions. Ivan, how can people get your book?
Well, it's basically anywhere, Indigo, Amazon, basically in all major bookstores, or you can get to the Guernica website, and it's very easy to get it there.
Excellent. And Ivan, how can people follow what's going on with you and what you're up to? Do you have a website, or are you on social media at all?
Yeah, Valentino, I need to follow this modern day. So I do have a website, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. So I'm quite everywhere. So that's my name, no other nickname.
Thank you so much for sharing your journey, as well as the journey of these characters here. I feel that your book is extremely inspiring, and I just want to say thank you so much for coming on to HOWL. It's been a real pleasure speaking with you.
It's for likewise, Valentino. So thank you for good questions, nice conversation, and yeah, have a good day.
Strangers are coming, they come to your house, they kill you all and say, "We're not guilty, not guilty." Where is your mind? Humanity cries. You think you are God, but everyone dies. Don't swallow my soul, our souls.
Oh, This is CIUT 89.5 FM. My name is Valentino Assenza. You're listening to HOWL, and that was a song by Ukrainian singer Jamala. It was called 1944. Occasionally what I'll do is, for the authors that I interview, I'll ask if they'd like to have a song played. And that was requested by Ivan Bidak. And thank you so much, Ivan, for selecting that song. Thank you also for the interview. The name of his book is Invisible by Guernica Editions. I would heavily encourage you to pick the book up. Proceeds, a portion of the proceeds from that book are going to an organization called Help the Heroes of Ukraine. So thank you, Ivan. So my next...